This video was produced by students for training purposes only and is provided on an as-is basis. ISU and the state of Idaho make no warranties about the completeness, reliability, usefulness, or accuracy of this information. Any action you take upon the information provided is strictly at your own risk, and ISU and the state of Idaho will not be liable for any errors, omissions, losses, or damages in connection with the use of the contents of this video.
This video is to demonstrate how to set up a flight plan in Mission Planner 1.3.41. In this mission, we will be using a 3DR Solo UAS with a 3-axis gimbal for a GoPro camera and a GoPro Hero 4 camera. You will also need a laptop with Mission Planner installed and an Android tablet or phone with a 3DR Solo app and Tower app installed. The first thing you'll want to do is open Mission Planner on your computer. Navigate to your area of interest on the map. You can use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. When you get to your area of interest, right-click and select the option Set Home Here. This will tell the UAS where it's starting and ending its mission. Choose a location that is accessible, suitable for takeoff and landing, and away from hazards. Now right-click again and select Draw Polygon, Add Polygon Point. A warning message will appear. Click OK. Here you will draw the polygon that you want your UAS to fly. For this demonstration, we will draw a square with 4 points. You can move these points by clicking the bottom of the markers and dragging them to a new location. As you are drawing your polygon, make sure you're avoiding obstacles such as trees, buildings, or power lines. Locate your home location and make sure that it is near one corner of the polygon, close to where you may launch and land in the field. After you have completed your polygon, right-click and select Draw Polygon, Save Polygon. After saving the polygon, right-click and select Auto Waypoint, Survey Grid. A pop-up window will appear. In the display box, make sure that the advanced options are selected. Select your camera from the options. We are using a GoPro Hero 4. If you're using a different camera and it isn't listed, you will click the Camera Config tab and enter the correct specs for your camera. Most specs can be found online from the manufacturer. You will need focal length, image width, image height, sensor width, and sensor height. Although the GoPro camera is not ideal for photogrammetry, we use it for training purposes. Back in the Simple tab, select your altitude in meters. For this demonstration, we will use 50 meters. Adjust the angle to adjust the direction of your grid lines. You will want them parallel to the longest side of your polygon. Try to avoid having small segments in the grid. Once they have been adjusted, make sure that the waypoints are in numerical order, starting at the home location and moving down the grid. Make sure the camera top facing forward is checked. Select your flying speed. An ideal flying speed ranges from 3 to 5 meters per second. We will use a slow flying speed of 3 meters per second. Make sure that the Add takeoff and land waypoints and use RTL are checked. In the Grid Options tab, adjust the overlap and side lap options. Set your overlap to 80% and set your side lap between 75 and 80%. In the Camera Config tab, in the Trigger Method box, select Do Digicam Control. This selection will assist with geotagging images once the flight is complete. After doing all of these configurations, look to the bottom of the pop-up window for the stats. Check the flight time, ground resolution, and the distance values, and make sure they adhere to the manufacturer's guidelines for your UAS. We will create a short flight plan for this demonstration. Check that your waypoints are still in numerical order. If anything is incorrect, you can move the red polygon points or adjust the angle in the Simple tab to correct the flight. In the Simple tab, click Accept to finalize your plan. If you want to fix or redo your plan, right-click and select Clear Mission and click Auto Waypoint, Survey Grid, Start Over. At the bottom of the screen will be waypoint stats. Make sure the latitude and longitude points make sense and that your altitude matches what you inputted. Check the waypoint tolerance on the map and make sure none of them overlap. Checking the waypoint radius will help as well. In this example, we will use a radius of 5 meters. After your mission is set up, click Save Waypoint File on the right side of the screen and save it to a hard drive to access it later. Thank you for watching this video on how to set up a flight plan in Mission Planner. Later videos will explain how to upload this flight plan to your UAS.